Hello, and welcome to the video for the TI Precision Lab discussing electrical overstress, or EOS, Part 2. In this video, we'll discuss more devices which are used for EOS protection, such as bidirectional TVS diodes, ferrite beads, and RC filters. We'll also discuss how the internal input protection and ESD structures of op-amps behave during EOS events. The ferrite bead, or ferrite chip, is a device which is useful for protecting against the effects of radio frequency or RF energy coupled to a circuit's input or output. At DC and low frequencies, the resistance of the ferrite bead is practically zero. At high frequencies, the resistance increases significantly, as shown in the figure on the bottom right. The characteristics of several ferrites are shown, but you can see that the resistance can increase to over 800 ohms at 200 MHz. The ferrite bead is especially useful in cases where a large fixed resistor is not practical and RF pickup is a problem. In EOS 1, we introduced the transient voltage suppressor, or TVS diode. Let's now discuss the bidirectional TVS diode. This device simply acts like two TVS diodes connected at their cathode. It will remain off from the negative breakdown voltage to the positive breakdown voltage. Once the breakdown voltage is exceeded, it will turn on and dissipate large amounts of power. A bidirectional TVS diode can be used to protect the input or output of an amplifier circuit. At the input, the TVS diode limits the input voltage to levels which are safe for the op-amp. An RC circuit is used to attenuate fast input transients, which we'll discuss more on the next slide. The output protection uses a ferrite bead and a bidirectional TVS diode to again limit the output voltage to safe levels. The ferrite bead is used in the output because a fixed resistor would introduce voltage drop errors and possibly limit the output swing. Note, however, that the ferrite bead does not offer protection against low-frequency EOS events. We discussed in EOS Part 1 that EOS events can be long events of milliseconds or more. However, EOS events can also be short transient pulses of high voltage. In these cases, a simple RC low-pass filter can help minimize the input transient. This example considers an EOS event at the input of an op-amp circuit. An RC low-pass filter is placed on the input with a cutoff frequency of 1 kHz and therefore a time constant of 160 microseconds. A general rule of thumb for RC circuits is that the filtered voltage will reach 63% of full value after one time constant and will be nearly fully charged at 5 time constants. The effect of the RC circuit on an overvoltage pulse can be seen in this simulation example. The pulse is 25 volts high and 100 microseconds wide. 100 microseconds is less than one time constant, so the pulse will not even reach 63% of its maximum value. Looking at the transient simulation, the op-amp's input voltage is limited to a safe level of 14 volts. Of course, the effectiveness of this method depends on the bandwidth of the circuit and the magnitude and timing of the overvoltage pulse. Besides the input and output pins, another common entry point for harmful EOS energy is the power supply. The TVS diode is also effective in suppressing EOS energy on the power supply. Filtering, such as the PI filter shown here, can also minimize the amplitude of any power supply glitch. Exceeding the maximum differential input voltage on amplifiers will also cause EOS damage. Some amplifiers allow the differential input voltage to be equal to the supply voltage. On the other hand, some amplifiers only allow for a relatively small differential input voltage, such as 0.7 volts. This small differential input is common in bipolar amplifiers, where the differential input pair is sensitive to a base-to-emitter breakdown, which can cause substantial damage to the device. Because of this sensitivity, a pair of diodes are connected to the input to limit the voltage to a safe level. If a differential input greater than the diode drop is applied, the diodes will limit the voltage. Although the diodes protect the input from breakdown damage, the diodes can be damaged if excessive current flows through them. Remember, the absolute maximum input current for most amplifiers is 10 milliamps, so the current flow into these diodes must be limited to less than 10 milliamps. Let's look at an example of when a large differential voltage can develop on an op-amp. Applying a square wave to the voltage follower circuit shown here causes the device to become slew rate limited, as discussed in TIPL 1221 through 1223. When an amplifier is slew rate limited, it is possible for very large differential input voltages to develop. For example, when the input transitions from plus 5 to minus 5 volts, the output cannot instantaneously follow that transition. Thus, the instant the transition occurs, the differential input could be the full 10 volts. However, the back-to-back diodes limit the input to 0.7 volts. Without some type of current limitation, large currents can flow during this time. To prevent this, input resistor RP is used to limit the current during slew limit to less than 10 milliamps. The transient plots on the right show how the resistor limits the input current to less than 10 milliamps, and the back-to-back diodes limit the differential input voltage to less than 1 volt. In the previous slides, we described the most common ESD structures. However, in some cases, process technology limitations or device performance requirements necessitate the use of different protection structures. Here we show the ESD protection devices inside the OPA-364 op-amp. The inputs of the OPA-364 have the familiar ESD diodes, but they also have SCR devices. An SCR, or silicon-controlled rectifier, is a diode that will latch on once a maximum voltage is applied across it. It acts very much like the absorption device that was discussed in the video on ESD. In this case, the SCRs on the input will turn on when the input voltage is greater than 15 volts. Note that this amplifier has an absolute maximum voltage of 5.5 volts, so 15 volts should never be applied to the input. Nevertheless, if the input voltage exceeds 15 volts, the SCR structure will turn on, large current will flow, and the SCR will not turn off until power is cycled. The reason that the SCR is included is that it is capable of turning on much faster than the ESD diodes for mitigating ESD transients. So the SCR devices are very helpful for ESD protection when the device is off, but may cause issues during an EOS event that occurs when the device is powered on. The output also contains an SCR device and ESD diodes with current limiting resistors. The resistors are used to prevent damage to the ESD diodes from inductive kickback, which may occur in some applications. Finally, the absorption device, TS, is designed for a fast turn-on of about 10 nanoseconds. Note that during a reverse polarity connection, diode DS across the absorption device will turn on and conduct large amounts of current, which could cause damage. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.